So last class we did the problems on conjugate lines and conjugate points. Okay. So today the other problem is find the angle between pair of tangents from 0 comma 0 to the circle x squared plus y squared minus 14x plus 2y plus 25 equal to 0. Okay. We have to find the angle between pair of tangents. So here first we write the equation of circle x squared plus y squared minus 14x plus 2y plus 25 is equal to 0. Okay. Now the angle between pair of tangents. The angle between pair of tangents is theta is equal to 2 tan inverse r by root s y 1. So formula to find angle between pair of tangents. So r is a radius, root s y 1 is a notation we have to find. So first we find out the radius. So how to find the radius? R is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. So r is equal to under root of g value is 7. So 7 squared, f value is 1, so 1 squared minus c, minus 25. So r is equal to under root of 50 minus 25 is 25, so r value is 5, r is equal to 5. Now after getting r, we find out root s11. So root s11 is equal to under root of x1 squared plus y1 squared plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c. So we find out root s11. So root s11 is equal to c. x1, y1 is a point. What is the point we get first? 0, comma 0. So when we substitute 0, comma 0 instead of x1, y1, all these ones get eliminated. Wherever we have x1, y1, only the c will be left out. So that is under root of only c value. C value is 25. So root s11 is nothing but again it is 5. So now angle between pair of tangents is theta is equal to 2 tan inverse r by root s11. So that is 5 by 5. So theta by 2 is equal to tan inverse, we get 1. So theta by 2 is equal to tan inverse 1. So theta by 2 is equal to tan inverse 1 is nothing but pi by 4. So we write pi by 4 or 45 degrees, meaning you can write pi by 4 or 45. So what is theta? Theta is nothing but 90 degrees. So what is angle between pair of tangents? It is theta 90 degrees. So this is completed. Now next problem, find the angle between tangents. Angle between pair of tangents from t comma 2 to the circle x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 4y minus 2 is equal to 0. So first we write the given equation of circle x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 4y minus 2 is equal to 0. So angle between pair of tangents is nothing but theta is equal to tan inverse r by root s11, right? So first we find out radius. So r is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. R is equal to under root of g value is half of 6, that is minus 3 square plus f value is half of y coefficient, this 2 square minus c, so it is plus 2. So r is equal to under root of 9 plus 4 plus 2. So r is equal to under root of 15. So r value is root 15. After getting r, we need to find root s11. So root s11 is equal to under root of x1 squared plus y1 squared plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c. So root s11 is equal to under root of, what is x1? x1 is 3, 3 square is 9. y1 is 2, 2 square is 4, 2g, 2g is nothing but the coefficient of x in the linear equation of circle, it is minus 6, minus 6 into x1, 2f is coefficient of y from the circle equation, it is 4 into y1 plus c. So root x11 is equal to under root of 13 minus 18 plus 8 minus 2. So root x11 is equal to 13 minus 18 is minus 5. Minus 5 plus 8 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. So square root of 1 is nothing but 1. So root x11 is 1. Now we need to find out the angle. So it is theta is equal to 2 tan inverse r by root x11. So r is root 15. Root 15 by r by root x11. Root 15 by 1 is nothing but root 15. Now we need to find out theta, but theta is equal to, we have 2, its multiple is there. So we need only theta. So that is the reason what we do. Theta by 2 is equal to tan inverse root 15. So tan theta by 2 is equal to root 15. Tan theta by 2 is equal to root 15. Now, but still we didn't get the value of theta. So what we do is, to get the value of theta, we have one more formula. Cos theta is equal to 1 minus tan square theta by 2y, 1 plus tan square theta by 2y. Again we are bringing cos theta. Reason is, we only got theta by 2 in terms of tan, but we need only theta. So that is the reason we are finding out this cos theta. So cos theta is equal to 1 minus tan square theta by 2, root 15 whole square we have to do, that is 15 by 1 plus 15. So cos theta is equal to 14 by 16. Cos theta is equal to 14 by 16. Then theta is equal to cos inverse 14 by 16 is nothing but it is 7 by 8. 2 7 is 2 8. So theta is equal to cos inverse 7 by 8 is the angle. Okay, so the angle between pair of tangents for this problem is theta is equal to cos inverse 7 by 8. Okay, this is completed. Now, one similar problem, you please try to solve this one. Find the angle between pair of tangents from 1 comma p to the circle x square plus y square minus 2x plus 4y minus 7 is equal to 0. Okay, you try to solve this problem.
See, now we'll start exercise 1e. In that 1e, the first point is we have relative position of two circles. So here we have two circles, R1 and R2 are the radii of two circles, okay. C1 and C2 are the centers of two circles, and what is D? D is the distance between two centers. D is the distance between two centers. The relative position of two circles are as follows. So here we have different cases. So first case is D greater than R1 plus R2. If D greater than R1 plus R2, two circles do not intersect. See, that is a diagram. Two circles do not intersect. What is D? D is actually the distance between two centers. Okay. R1 and R2 are the radii. So if D is greater than R1 plus R2, the relative position of two circles is they do not intersect. Okay. Second one. If D less than R1 plus R2, the two circles intersect each other. If D less than R1 plus R2, two circles intersect each other. Then third one, D is equal to R1 plus R2. D is equal to R1 plus R2 means two circles touch each other externally. So here again I am repeating, D is the distance between two centers. Okay, but in the diagram we have shown D not exactly on the centers, but remember D is the distance between two centers. R1 and R2 are the radii. If D is equal to R1 plus R2, two circles touch each other externally at one point. Okay, next one. If D is equal to difference of R1 and R2, we denote it as mod of r1 minus r2. If d is r1 minus r2, two circles touch each other internally. So one circle is there, the second circle will lie inside of the first circle. So two circles touch each other internally if d is equal to r1 minus r2. Okay, then after that we have some definitions. First one is direct common tangent. Okay, so what is direct common tangent? If two circles are on the same side of a tangent, see here in the diagram you can see two circles are there, the two circles are on the same side of a tangent. Okay, if two circles are on the same side of a tangent, the tangent is called direct common tangent. Direct common tangent we denote it as DCT. Okay, so if two circles lie on the same side of a tangent, it is a direct common tangent. And next one we have transverse common tangent. Transverse common tangent means what? Two circles should lie on either side of a tangent. So here in the diagram you can see we have two circles. The tangent is there, but what about the two circles? The position of two circles is on the either side. One is on the right side, the other one is on the left side. So if two circles are on the either side of a tangent, the tangent is transverse common tangent. Okay. Then after that, internal center of similitude. The next one is internal center of similitude. So what is internal center of similitude? The point of intersection of transverse common tangents is internal center of similitude. Now you know what is transverse common tangent. Two circles should lie on either side of a tangent. Now here you have two circles. For these two circles we have a direct transverse common tangent. We have a transverse common tangent. See, this is a transverse common tangent, and here also we have one more transverse common tangent. These two tangents intersect at one point, so this point is called internal center of similitude. We denote it as ICS. Next is external center of similitude. So what is external center of similitude? The point of intersection of direct common tangents is external center of similitude. The point of intersection of direct common tangents is external center of similitude. Now here you have two circles. What are direct common tangents? Two circles should lie on same side of a tangent. Now this is a tangent. Two circles are on the same side. Now these two tangents intersecting at one point. Direct common tangents are intersecting at one point. So this point is known as external center of similitude. Okay. Next we have formulas, right? Now we have a formula for ICS and we have a formula for ECS. So now x1 y1 and x2 y2 are the centers of two circles. R1 and R2 are the respective radii. Okay, then internal center of similitude is given by R1 x2 plus R2 x1 by R1 plus R2. Next one is the y coordinate is R1 y2 plus R2 y1 by R1 plus R2. This is internal center of similitude. For external center of similitude, the formula is same, but only thing is we get a minus sign. That is R1 x2 minus R2 x1. R1 x2 minus R2 x1 by R1 minus R2. Then we have R1 y2 minus R2 y1 by R1 minus R2. So this is a formula for ICS and ECS, you have to remember. So after that we have a different cases. Now you know what is a direct common tangent. What is a direct common tangent? Two circles should lie on the same side of a tangent, then it is a direct common tangent. Transverse common tangent means two circles should lie on either side of a tangent. Common tangent means what? It is a combination of direct common tangent and transverse common tangent. So here we have again four different cases. The first one is if d greater than r1 plus r2, we say the two circles do not intersect. So if two circles do not intersect, how many direct common tangents can be drawn? See, this one is a direct common tangent, straight line like this. And the second one is, this is also a direct common tangent, straight line. Okay, direct common tangent, two direct common tangents. And transverse common tangents, circle should lie on either side, this one and this one. These are the two, which one you are seeing like an X, these are the transverse common tangents. So what are common tangents? you have to add DCT and TCT. Both you add, you will get a common tangent. Total is 4. Okay, next. If D less than R1 plus R2, two circles intersect each other. Now, this is intersecting. Now, in this case, how many direct common tangents? This is a direct common tangent and this is a direct common tangent. So, two direct common tangents we can draw. Here, we can't get a transverse common tangent because see, if you draw a line like this, we will get a line, but that line is not a tangent, that line is a common chord. So, this is not a tangent. So, we can't draw transverse common tangent in this case. So, transverse common tangents are 0. So, now add these two. 2 plus 0 is 2. So, common tangents are 2. Then, third one is if D is equal to R1 plus R2. If D is equal to R1 plus R2, two circles touch each other externally. Okay. So, these are the two circles touch each other externally. In this case, direct common tangent, see the one which is starting from here and the other one is starting from here, two direct common tangents. And this one, the tangent is called transverse common tangent. So, how many direct common tangents? Two. This is one and this is one. Two. Transverse common tangent is only one. So, common tangent means add these two. 2 plus 1 is 3. So, we have one more case, fourth one. If D is equal to R1 minus R2, mod of R1 minus R2, two circles touch each other internally. Now, this is internal. Two circles touch each other internally. So, now we can draw one tangent for this. This tangent is nothing but a direct common tangent. Why it is called a direct common tangent? Because the two circles are on the same side of a tangent. So, that's why direct common tangent is 1. So, we can't get a transverse common tangent. It is 0. So, common tangent means just add these two. 1 plus 0 is 1. Okay, so these are very, very important. You will get one 7 marks question from exercise 1E. Okay, so please refer all these notes. All these points are very, very important so that we can start the class. So now we do one problem on relative position of two circles. So here, discuss the relative position of two circles. So these are the two equations of circles. So, in order to get the position of two circles, first what we do, we find the center of a circle. The center of a circle is 2, 3, and the center of the second circle is -3, -9. Right? Now we find out radius. R1 is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. G square plus f square minus c. Minus c minus. So here R1 is equal to the root 25 unit, that is the number 5. Now we find out R2. R2 is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. 9 plus 81 minus 26. G square plus f square minus c. So R2 is equal to under root of 81 plus 9. 81 plus 9 is 90. Minus 26. So R2 is equal to root 64. So what is root 64? We get 8. Root 64, 8. So R2 is 8. Now after getting R1 and R2, we find out D. So what is D? D is nothing but the distance between two centers. So these are the two centers. We find out distance between two points, that is x2 minus x1 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, that is 3 plus 9 whole square. So d is equal to under root of, that is 2 plus 3, 5, 5 square, 25, 3 plus 9, 12, 12 square is 144. So 25 plus 144 is 169. So D is equal to under root of 169. So what is the value of D here getting? This root 169 is 13. So after getting D value, we have R1 and R2. So in order to check the relative position of two circles, we need to check either D greater than R1 plus R2 or D less than R1 plus R2 or D is equal to R1 plus R2 or D is equal to R2.
minus R2 is nothing but it is 5 plus 8. So R1 plus R2 is 13. So clearly D is equal to R1 plus R2. So what are the relative position of two circles? The two circles touch each other. The two circles touch each other externally. Two circles touch each other externally. So this problem is completed. See, next problem we try. Find the relative position of two circles. X squared plus y squared plus 6x plus 6y plus 14 is equal to 0. And the second circle equation is x squared plus y squared minus 2x minus 4y minus 4 is equal to 0. So you try this, whether you get D is equal to R1 plus R2 or D greater than R1 plus R2 or D less than R1 plus R2 or D is equal to R1 plus R2. Try this problem. Okay. So next problem. Find the number of possible common tangents to the following circles. So circle equations are x squared plus y squared minus 4x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0. And x squared plus y squared minus 6x minus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. So first what we do is, we check again all those four conditions. D is equal to R1 plus R2, D greater than R1 plus R2, D less than R1 plus R2, or D is equal to R1 plus R2. Depending on those conditions, we can decide how many common tangents we get. So first we find out the center, 2 comma 1 we get. Okay, and here the center is 3 comma 2. Okay, we got the center. R1 is under root of g square plus f square minus c. So R1 is 2 because plus 1 minus 1 cancels, square root of 2. Then R2 is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. G square plus f square minus c. So 4 cancels. R2 is square root of 9, 3. Now we find out D. D is distance between two centers. It is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square. That is 2 minus 3 whole square plus 1 minus 2 whole square. So D is equal to under root of 1 plus 1. So D value is root 2 here. So D value is root 2. Irrational number, no problem. Now check R1 and R2. So what is R1 plus R2? R1 plus R2 is 2 plus 3. That is 5. Now square root of 2 is approximately square root of 2. Square root of 2 is approximately 1.4. 1.414, that is 1.4. So D is 1.4. R1 plus R2 is 5. So clearly we can say that D is less than R1 plus R2 because 1.4 and that is 5. 1.4 is less than 5. So D is less than R1 plus R2. So we say two circles intersect. Two circles intersect each other. That means if two circles intersect each other, just we draw that condition. Draw that case. Two circles intersect each other. So this is the condition. Two circles intersect each other. In this case, how many direct common tangents can be drawn? Two. So how many direct common tangents can be drawn? Two direct common tangents. Transverse common tangents are not possible in this case. So it is zero. So how many common tangents can be drawn? So common tangents, just add these two. 2 plus 0 is 2. So therefore, the number of common tangents drawn to these circles is nothing but 2. Okay, so this is completed. Okay, next problem. Find the internal center of similitude. Find the internal center of similitude for the circles x squared plus y squared plus 6x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0 and x squared plus y squared minus 2x minus 6y plus 9 is equal to 0. So here to find the internal center of similitude or external center of similitude, both the cases we need center of the first circle. It is minus 3 comma 1 and the center of second circle is 1 comma 3. Okay, so these are the center of two circles. Now radius of both the circles. R1 is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. R1 is 3. Then R2 is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. So R2 is 1. Now reading both the centers and radii, what is ICS? ICS formula is given by R1x2 plus R2x1 by R1 plus R2 comma R1 by 2 plus R2y1 by R1 plus R2. Okay, so formula here. Now what we do, we substitute this. See, what is x1, y1 and x2, y2? X1, y1, x2, y2 are the center. So this is x1, y1, y2 and this is x2, y2. Already you have R1 and R2. So we substitute now. So ICS is equal to R1. R1 is 3. 3 into x2. What is x2? X2 is 1. Plus R2. R2 is 1. Into x1. X1 is minus 3. Y. R1 plus R2. Add 3 plus 1 is 4. R1 plus R2. Comma. R1 is 3. And what is Y2? Y2 is 3. R1 by 2 plus R2 by 1. R2 by 1. 1 into 1. Y. R1 plus R2 is 4. So now 3 ones are 3. 3 minus 3 by 4. 3 minus 3 by 4. Comma. And next one is 9 plus 1 by 4. So what is ICS we are getting? 3 minus 3 is 0. 0 by anything is 0. And here we get 10 by 4. See, what is 10 by 4? 10 by 4 is nothing but 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4. So what is ICS? It is 0 comma 5 by 2. So this is completed. So next problem, find the external center of similitude of the following circles. These two circles, x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y plus 9 is equal to 0 and x square plus y square is equal to 4. Now, what is the center of the circle? It is 1 comma 3. Now, what is the center of x square plus y square is equal to 4? Now, this equation is given in the form x square plus y square is equal to r square. That means we write this equation as x square plus y square is equal to 2 square. Now, what is the center of the circle? The center of the circle is 0 comma 0. And what is the radius? R square is equal to 2 square. So R is equal to 2. So what is the center of the second circle? It is R2 is 2. This is R2. R2 is 2. So you find out center of the first circle. Okay. Radius of the first circle. Then find out external center of similitude. Easiest. Write out the formula and find it. Okay. So this class is completed.